Hello and welcome to my channel, Lavina Lou Diaries. Because you all loved my last video with the Ashdin doctor, so we thought on making series of video. And in today's video, we are going to talk about career and how to grow in your career. I wanted to ask you that there are so many people who want to reach a certain goal, but they are very unhappy in their career, but they're still doing it. Should they continue in their unhappy environment of working, or they should just walk out?
What should they do, right?
Yeah, what should they do?
You raise such an important point, because this is such an interesting thing to note that most people don't have a goal.
Oh. Right?
So if you don't have a goal, how do you know in which direction you're heading?
True.
See, think about it. When you're in college,
okay,
your mommy, daddy put you in one engineering or one science or
right,
one this, and then that decided what you're going to be doing for the rest of your life.
Correct, because so many people, they don't know what they want to do.
They don't know what to do.
Yeah.
And at that age, how can you possibly know what to do?
True.
Correct?
True.
So you start, and then you say, acha, acha, opportunity aa gaya, so I took it.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Whenever we do interviews in our office, people say, I'm looking for new opportunities. But what does that mean? Right?
Right. Unless
you need to be clear. You need to know where you're going.
Yeah.
Correct? So one of the most important thing is to actually start looking around and understanding which industries are growing.
Mm-hmm.
Because you want to grow along with an industry.
True.
Right?
And one needs to know that what skill acquires so that he or she can proceed in that direction.
Correct.
Right?
And how to keep getting new skills along the way.
Okay.
Right? So that's the most important thing.
Okay.
In fact, you stole my first habit.
Okay.
Because that's exactly what it's about.
Okay.
Right? So the first habit for how do you get your career supercharged and growing,
yeah,
is understanding something very simple.
Uh-huh.
That you don't have a money problem or a lack of salary problem.
Mm-hmm.
You have a lack of skills problem.
Okay.
Right? Because if you only upgrade your skills,
mm-hmm,
you can upgrade your salary.
True. So
right?
The first thing is to know your goals.
One
is know your goals, and one is to know your skills.
Know your skills.
Skills.
And then keep upgrading your skills. In the last 6 months, if you haven't learned something new,
mm-hmm,
if you haven't done an online course,
mm-hmm,
how are you possibly going to further yourself?
Yeah, right. So you mean to say that whatever I know, I need to master that area.
Correct. Master
right?
the area and then grow. That area and then
yeah,
grow.
So keep learning.
Keep learning.
And when you get the right opportunity, that's when you hit it.
Like. Correct. That's when you change. That's when you look for something.
Right.
Right. Because you're going to be an executive, then you're going to be a manager. The two are very different.
Yeah.
A manager has to learn how to deal with people. An executive has to learn how to actually execute things.
Right.
So if you're growing, you have to learn how to grow and acquire.
So basically you're saying that you have to be prepared for the opportunity.
You have to be ready.
Ready. So you have to keep upgrading yourself in the meantime.
Yes.
And then when the opportunity arises, you need to grab it. So you're prepared and you excel at that.
Absolutely.
So okay,
one new skill every 6 months is the habit. That's how
to
you're
grow.
Going to grow.
Yeah, correct? That's perfect.
So read lots of books, do online courses, something.
Yeah, fine.
The second habit is very interesting.
Okay.
It's about focus. Many a times you're at work,
mm-hmm,
and you're on your phone, or an email comes and you get distracted, or a friend comes and you get distracted.
Okay.
What's happening now is that our entire world is filled with distractions.
Yeah, and also I want to add to that, even stress.
Hmm.
You know, a lot of people have so many things to deal with that they forget to concentrate on one thing.
Correct.
You know, multitasking is different, but shifting the focus from the main goal is different.
Yeah.
So you need to have an eye for what exactly you want, right?
At that point of time, what you're doing, if you're working on a presentation, you should only be working on a presentation.
Correct.
You shouldn't be thinking about what should I make for food at home.
Correct.
Right? You shouldn't be thinking about why I had a fight with so-and-so the other day.
Right. So you give you 100%.
100%.
Correct.
Okay. And there's a very simple technique that I teach.
Mm-hmm.
It's called the Pomodoro technique.
Pomodoro. Okay. So I don't know. So can you
Pomodoro
just
Pomodoro is a kitchen timer. You know those oven ka timers that you have?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So all you do is you set an alarm for 25 minutes.
Okay.
Right? For those 25 minutes, you put off the internet, you put off your phone, you put off everything.
Okay.
Zero distractions.
Okay.
And you only focus on that work.
Okay. Only focus on that work, putting off everything.
Everything else.
Everything. Okay.
Okay.
That's
after
nice.
Those 25 minutes are over and that thing goes ding.
Yeah.
Correct?
Yeah.
Then next 5 minutes, you take a break.
That's okay. Nice. That's interesting.
And then you keep doing
this. Yeah.
So that's called the Pomodoro technique. Pomodoro technique.
Okay. That's quite nice because you have 25 minutes, so you can easily do it.
You can easily do something in that much time.
Correct. And increase your concentration and your focus.
Correct. Absolutely.
That's a good way to practice.
Yes.
That's nice. So what's the third habit?
So the third habit leads to the first one as well.
Okay.
Every 6 months, I want you to do a personal review.
Personal review.
Of your goal.
of your goal. Okay.
Right?
Okay.
So, am I in line with my goal? Is what I'm doing going to help me succeed in my goal? Because otherwise, very often you're heading in one direction, suddenly the path goes a little different, and now you're heading in another direction, but your goal was in that direction.
Right. So you mean to say that I might be interested a couple of months back, I might be interested in something, but later I might realize, I'm not interested, you know?
Correct.
So you need to figure out, right?
You need to figure out what you want.
Okay, what you want.
Because life
and
keeps
still
changing.
You're interested.
And still you're interested or not.
Correct.
Right? Life keeps changing, so that's why every 6 months you should do a review.
Yeah.
Right? Is my job in line with my goals?
Mm-hmm.
Do I have the right skills?
Mm-hmm.
Is this the way I want to live my life?
Like, are you happy in what you're doing? Right?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
You might be working in a call center late in the night.
Uh-huh.
Is that what you want to be doing for the rest of your life? Is this in line with your goals? You're saying, nahin, abhi ke liye it is putting food on my plate, so I'm happy.
You said an important point, because I also feel there are so many people who are just wasting time in doing what they don't love.
Correct.
Just for the sake of money or n number of reasons, whatever it may be. I personally believe that even though it may take longer to reach your goal, focus and do things in your direction. Suppose if you want to become a photographer, so you know, do that course. Not that you want to do photographer, but you're doing engineering.
Correct.
Or if you want to be an engineer, you're doing photography. Just don't waste your time, because you only reach your goal when you are at it and you keep practicing your profession.
Absolutely.
And if you're doing different things, there's a very little chance you might reach your goal. But when you keep walking in same direction, I think there's 100% chance that you might reach your goal.
Correct. So finding out the goal,
mm-hmm.
and then doing something that is in line with it.
Mm-hmm.
So in fact, the next habit is about having a side business or
a side hustle. So that you don't have that pressure of, you know, running your kitchen. You can have that side business and plus pursue your career.
So the career is going on because the career is giving you what is the money that you're going to be spending every month.
Okay.
But the side business is you're thinking 3 years down the line. You're thinking 4 years down the line. You're being patient with it because you're acquiring skills.
Okay.
You're saying, this is how I want to be living my life.
But I thought it's the other way around. To have a side business so that you can focus on your career. Sometimes your career does not give you money, but you need to run your kitchen, right? So that's when that, you know, you can have a side business, and because that's giving you money, you can keep practicing or pursuing, doing your course, whatever.
So the career normally is the one that will have more money than the side business. Otherwise, you quit the career. So what happens in people's life is that, for example, the call center, since we were on that, the call center job could be giving you 60,000, say.
Right.
Correct? That's how you're running the home.
Yeah.
But you're interested in photography.
Right.
So you do the photography on the weekends.
Okay.
You do the photography on the hours that you're not working.
Right.
And you get good at that.
Okay. What I wanted to ask you, because sometimes, you know, in certain career, it takes really long. To, you know, get there, know the people and reach your goal. So it takes longer. Like, for example, I'm an actor, so it really takes long. You need to be patient. Maybe I might get a good film after 2 years, 3 years. So, but this does not give me money all the time, because I want to choose my role, you know.
Correct.
So then I have to have a side business which gives me earning, but still I want to focus on my career.
Right.
Because that is my ultimate goal, running a restaurant or whatever. The side business is not my primary goal.
So I would look at it differently, saying that the business that's giving you more money is your career.
Is your career.
The business that's giving you less money is your side business.
But
so acting could be your side business till it becomes more money and it becomes your career.
Yeah.
So the fourth habit is to actually have a passion project.
Passion project. Okay.
Or a side business.
Okay.
Why is this important? Because very often our career is just giving us money, but it does not excite us.
Right.
It is not something that we want to do for the rest of our life.
Right.
Correct. So we have to find something that we want to do for the rest of our life.
Perfect.
And that becomes a passion project or a side business.
Fine. So you get money from and invest in your passion project.
And you invest in your passion project.
Perfect.
5 years down the line, hopefully the passion project will be so big that you don't have to work in that other career anymore. Right.
Perfect.
Then this becomes your new career and this becomes your new way of working.
I think that's wonderful that you, even though if you're doing something, so you should remove time for your passion project and invest your time. So that side by side, that also keeps growing.
That keeps growing as well.
That's wonderful. Yeah.
Superb.
Yeah.
The last point is very important. It is that even if you're stuck in a business that does not excite you.
Okay.
Right? Very often people are stuck in businesses.
Yeah, because I know so many people, they are just running the house or correct. Whatever. So for just for money, they are just doing the business. But they are really not interested. Because they come back and say, yaar, you know, it's boring, but I have to continue because I have to pay my bills.
Correct. Right? And their attitude towards their work is so bad.
Uh-huh.
Because they're like, arey, work sucks.
Yeah.
I hate Mondays.
Yeah.
Right? So the whole idea is, how do you get out of this whole, I hate Mondays, work sucks?
Yeah.
Because ultimately, the energy that you bring to work is how everyone is responding to you.
Okay.
So even if you are not enjoying yourself,
mm-hmm.
you still have to bring that energy to work. And
okay.
I think that's an important habit to get in place.
Yeah.
Whenever you enter work, you should be full of energy because other people feed off that.
Yeah. So basically, to reach your goal or to grow in your career, you have to be happy, energetic and vibrant at your workplace.
Correct.
Right?
Right.
That is the fifth habit you need to grow.
To grow. Because we know so many people who walk into office saying, you know, life sucks, aray, nothing happened.
Basically, positive attitude.
Positive attitude is so important.
To
in a career.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So these five habits mm-hmm. will get you through and help your career grow much faster than what it is right now. Because
okay.
you have your goals in place.
Yeah.
You're growing every single step of the way.
Yes.
And your attitude is in line.
And plus you have your passion going on so that you can grow in that career.
Yes. Yes.
So I think that's a great idea. And we got to learn so much that how to grow in your career and become successful. And it was wonderful. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
So like I always say, your love is my inspiration. And keep it coming. And if you like my video, do not forget to subscribe, like, share and comment. And do not forget to hit that bell icon for my next video. Until then, see you. Bye-bye.